The Affordable Care Act kicks off today. What will it mean for Montgomery County? Coming up next on Capital News Service.
National monuments are closed due to the government shutdown. I'm Josh Birch, and I'll let you know how one group didn't let that interfere with their plans. Maryland Newsline starts now.
This is a fact. On the camera two, they go back to the two shots.
Take Francie G.
You're the number one.
Take him with three. Three, two, one.
I know it's strange that one party would make keeping people uninsured the centerpiece of their agenda, but that apparently is what it is.
An angry president and more than 100,000 Marylanders out of work. Good evening, I'm Christina Gatti, and this is Maryland Newsline.
And I'm Leslie Spacek. Welcome to Federal Government Shutdown 2013. Just over 18 hours ago, the Capitol Hill battle linking government funding and defunding Obamacare wound up in shutdown. Ripple effects are being felt throughout the state and the district tonight, as CNS TV's Josh Burke has discovered.
For the first time in 17 years, the federal government's doors are closed, the result of a congressional stalemate.
There are some people, regardless of what party you may be in, that didn't have the United States as a whole at heart.
James Oswalt is a World War II vet from Mississippi. He was part of a contingent that was in Washington to see the World War II memorial. The problem? The government shut down last night, effectively closing the monuments and museums on the National Mall. But this group was not to be stopped. The sign says this monument is closed, but several members of Congress thought it was so important to allow the veterans to come in that they removed the barriers themselves.
They have a tiny little window of opportunity to be here. They can't deal with bureaucratic red tape. I mean, when they're here, they got to go in. So we just did what we figured if we were here, we could use our authority and get these veterans in.
For veterans, it was difficult to put into words what this opportunity meant to them.
I never dreamed that we had a memorial this size. And I appreciate the effort that everybody's done for us.
Mississippi Congressman Greg Harper said it was an honor to share the experience with veterans from his state.
They really don't want you to say thank you, because to them, they were just doing their duty. But we owe an incredible debt of gratitude.
While the veterans may have gotten into this memorial, other popular tourist sites remain closed, leaving many visitors unhappy.
Just see a bunch of foolishness, and I think about, you know, children playing on the playground as kids and no one really wanting to get along.
Seems kind of silly. You know, we're not in junior high, so I feel like they need to make a decision and work together because that's what they're there for.
But for these visiting vets, they were just happy to share their last honor flight with each other.
This is tremendous. It's a wonderful, good thing to see out of Washington, D.C.
In Washington, Josh Birch, CNS TV.
Maryland senators just introduced a bill to ensure that federal workers get their back pay. The Federal Employee Retroactive Pay Fairness Act will cover all furloughed workers, according to Senators Ben Cardin and Barbara Mikulski.
And despite the government shutdown, some federally controlled services will stay open. The U.S. Postal Service will continue to deliver mail, Social Security and Medicare benefits will keep coming, and taxes will still be collected, just to name a few. And while all national parks and museums on the National Mall are closed, the Corcoran Gallery of Art, the museum, the National Geographic Museum, and others will be open for tourists. And the irony of the shutdown, while the federal government lost its funding at midnight last night, Obamacare began its first official day of the Affordable Health Care Act. I was in Rockville as some of the first Marylanders signed up for medical coverage. Sign-up is now underway for Maryland's Health Exchange, as provided in the President's Affordable Health Care Program. Actual coverage does not kick in until January 1st. Philip White is grateful for the opportunity to sign on.
I don't live nowhere. I'm homeless.
White suffers from inflammation in his legs brought on by a flu shot. The problem is, White can't afford to see a doctor regularly.
I mean, I was in so much pain, I couldn't even walk.
We have a tremendous number of individuals who are living on the edge.
Rockville's Mayor Phyllis Marcuccio joined with other local officials in kicking off the start of the enrollment period for the new program. But there were a few technical difficulties.
While the Maryland Health Exchange website was up and running by the noon launch, anyone trying to register probably saw this error message. But despite the early bugs with the system, supporters of the program are happy enrollment is underway.
Open enrollment for the program will end on March 31st, so clinics are urging people in Montgomery County to come on into the clinics and sign up.
Interfaith Works is a local nonprofit helping to get the word out about signing up for the program. The organization says about 52,000 residents in the county are currently without insurance coverage.
Our goal is to get every single one of them to be signed up for insurance.
County officials say they hope the affordable health care program will lift the burden of worry and bring stability to the people who need it.
Well, it'll make a lot of difference, not only for me, for other people too.
Rebecca Pierce, Executive Director of the Maryland Health Benefit Exchange, said the site should be running smoothly sometime tomorrow.
The fate of three former Naval Academy football players is in the hands of the Academy Superintendent tonight. Vice Admiral Michael Miller is reviewing a report on whether to move forward with sexual assault charges against the midshipmen. Miller could court-martial the three, punish them administratively, or drop the case. The three are accused of assaulting a female midshipman at an off-campus party last year.
The Transportation Security Administration says two Nevada men are facing charges in Maryland after dozens of fake IDs were found in a checked bag at BWI. TSA says an unidentifiable object in a checked bag set off an alarm, and officers found a stack of fraudulent cards inside it on Friday. Officials say the cards included several New York State driver's licenses and credit cards in different names.
Put that cell phone down. That's what Maryland police officers are saying to drivers because they can now pull you over for it. It's one of the several new state driving laws going into effect today. CNS-TV's Brandon Goldner explains the new rules to the road.
Your commute starting today will be less distracting. No texting, no calls, because the simple act of just holding your cell phone can now get you pulled over by the police. Prince George's County Police Corporal Maria McKinney says before today, officers had to find another traffic offense before citing someone for talking or texting.
Hopefully, with us pulling people over, issuing citations, it will give the would-be offender second thought to just pull over if they have to make that important phone call or make that important text.
The change in the law was approved earlier this year by the Maryland General Assembly, and it's not the only driving law going into effect today. It's now a secondary offense if a passenger in your car isn't buckled up. Most of the attention, though, is for the cell phone law, as many say the law will benefit drivers and pedestrians.
I think it's good as far as driver safety. Obviously, there's a lot of accidents that we have seen that are caused from people texting and driving. I think at least the law will bring more awareness of, when you are driving, to be more aware of what's happening around you.
But for some, the message may not yet have gone through. That text that can't wait could end up costing a driver $75 for a first offense and 3 points on your license if your actions contribute to an accident. In College Park, Brandon Goldner, CNS-TV.
Other new laws in effect today, cyberbullying is now a crime. The death penalty is repealed and makes designer drug K2 illegal.
Maryland public schools get a new curriculum, but many parents ask why.
And Maryland's new gun control laws went into effect today, without having to dodge any bullets on implementation. That's up next for Maryland Newsline.
Now what'd she say?
She said whatever.
No, she says that all the time.
What's that?
Hello? I'm on the phone. Mom, I'm on the phone! Hello? I'm on the phone.
Who's this? It's me. I'm on the phone. Mom.
Oh, you were on the phone. All right.
Sorry.
Anyway.
Who are you talking to? Kelly?
Mom.
All right.
You don't have to be perfect to be a perfect parent. There are thousands of teens in foster care who would love to put up with you.
Abandoned and lost. From the dark, cold streets of the city to a cage in the local shelter to heaven, your lap.
So my uncle
doctor calls and he says he's dizzy and he's losing his balance. I'm like, oh, you want me to take you to a doctor? He's like, no, I'm going to look up the symptoms. I said, your symptoms are you're dizzy and you're losing your balance. So he said, I can't get on the internet because my arm is numb. I said, well, use your good arm and dial 911. Stroke's no joke. If you or someone you love is showing symptoms of stroke, don't wait because it might be too late. Dial 911. Time lost is brain lost.
This financial advisor is being accused of committing one of the largest investment frauds in the history of the United States.
I guess we're not going to Aspen. That's fine. You see, I like tennis balls. He likes insider trading. So he's going to jail and I'm going to a shelter. And no, they're not the same thing. Shelters are for good pets that want to be adopted. Jails are for criminals. I've done nothing. Uh-oh. Okay, I stole a cheeseburger once. I'm a dog.
Welcome back to Maryland Newsline.
Gun rights advocates spent the day trying to shoot down Maryland's new restrictive law.
Tonight, more than a few new traffic laws are going into effect here in Maryland. Tough restrictions on gun ownership have just become law. But gun rights supporters took their best shot at blocking those restrictions. Today, I was there as a U.S. District Court in Baltimore made her decision.
The request for the temporary restraining order on Maryland's new gun laws was filed just last Friday. Today, attorneys representing gun owners and retailers were in Baltimore U.S. District Court arguing that the enforcement of the new laws should be delayed while they prepare to go to court to argue the constitutionality of the laws. Specifically, the plaintiffs wanted a delay on new handgun licensing requirements, as well as a delay on a ban against new purchases of certain types of automatic weapons and limits on detachable magazines. Opponents of the law argued that the Supreme Court has already ruled in favor of homeowners using guns for self-defense. But Assistant Attorney General Matt Fader, arguing for the state, said that the Supreme Court case did not identify any category of guns and recognized handguns as the most common firearm used for self-defense. Under the law, Fader argued, individuals still have the right to possess and purchase handguns. U.S. District Court Judge Catherine Blake said the plaintiff's argument did not prove the extraordinary relief or irreparable harm needed to grant a temporary restraining order.
Halting the provisions of law, what we're essentially talking about is a complete denial of the fundamental right to purchase the firearm of your choice for a legitimate purpose, self-defense.
As the Attorney General has made clear in the opinion letter he wrote, this law is constitutional. It will save lives, keep guns out of the hands of criminals and others who shouldn't have them, without infringing on the Second Amendment rights of anyone. The judge made that clear. And one of the things I want to state very clearly is that the plaintiffs...
The gun control opponents say that just because their request was denied by the judge, they'll still continue to challenge the constitutionality of the law.
Maryland parents have been getting quite an education in Maryland's curriculum lately, and not everyone is happy about it.
Tonight marks the last chance for a public input on a controversial new plan that has already inflamed tempers and led to one parent's arrest. CNS TV's Rachel Auerbach has this live report from Charles Herbert High School in Prince George's County. Rachel?
Leslie and Christina, this is the fourth and final public forum taking place around the state to discuss the new standards in Maryland public schools. The new curriculum called Common Core is now being used in grades K through 12. Many parents have questioned why the state is revising its education standards, especially considering Maryland schools have been ranked best in the nation for 5 straight years. The forums around Maryland are intended to give parents an opportunity to ask questions about the new curriculum, but parents are required to submit their questions in writing and are not allowed to voice questions from the floor. Some have criticized the Maryland Department of Education because of that. In fact, at the last forum in Baltimore County just over a week ago, one parent was arrested after he stood up and offered comments from the floor. The charges were later dropped. So we'll see if tonight's forum goes any smoother. Reporting live from Springdale, Rachel Auerbach, CNS TV.
Thank you, Rachel. Virginia's Chesapeake Bay oyster season opens today also. The tenfold increase in the state's oyster harvest in the past decade has attracted many poachers, although oysters are still only a fraction of historic highs in the bay and its tributaries. The Virginia Marine Resource Commission revoked the fishing licenses of 5 commercial oyster harvesters who pleaded guilty to over-harvesting last month.
Marine police are making poaching crackdowns a top priority.
Coming up on Maryland Newsline, the National Zoo's beloved panda cam has gone dark with the government shutdown.
And on the brighter side of the shutdown, some places around town are offering furlough freebies like food and drinks. Find out where next.
Advisor is being accused of committing one of the largest investment frauds in the history of the United States.
I guess we're not going to Aspen. That's fine. You see, I like tennis balls. He likes insider trading. So he's going to jail and I'm going to a shelter. And no, they're not the same thing. Shelters are for good pets that want to be adopted. Jails are for criminals. I've done nothing. Uh-oh. Okay, I stole a cheeseburger once. I'm my dog.
Folks, why won't we go to the doctor? My uncle called, speech all slurred, complaining his arm's numb. He called everyone. He even called my daughter Tierra, because, you know, she's got a year of nursing. Everyone thinks he needs to go to the doctor, including me. So he said, well, will you take me? I'm like, I'm on the road. He goes, I'll wait. Stroke's no joke. If you or someone you love have symptoms of stroke, don't wait. It may be too late. Dial 911. Time loss is brain loss.
I help you find a home.
I help you find a home.
Hey, maybe you'll be picnic.
Maybe you'll be picnic.
We've been caged together too long.
We've been caged together too long.
How come nobody ever picks me?
Maybe they're looking for somebody different.
Pick me.
Well, the shelter's closing up for another day.
I didn't get picked.
I know.
Tomorrow. Guaranteed.
What did she say?
She said whatever.
No, she says that all the time.
What's that?
Hello?
I'm on the phone. Mom, I'm on the phone!
Hello? I'm on the phone.
Who's this? It's me. I'm on the phone. Mom?
Oh, you're on the phone. All right.
Sorry.
Anyway.
Who are you talking to? Kelly?
Mom.
All right.
You don't have to be perfect to be a perfect parent. There are thousands of teens in foster care who would love to put up with you.
So what is the National Zoo's adorable new baby panda up to these days? Nobody but the zookeepers know for sure. The government shutdown has turned off panda cams. National Zoo staffers tweeted that because the two cameras need federal money to run, they're dark for now. Thousands of viewers worldwide log on every day to check Mei Xing and her six-week-old cub.
Uncle Sam may have forced thousands out of work today, but there are some perks in and around the district for those furloughed. Federal employees are getting everything from free burgers to drink specials thanks to the generosity of many local businesses. And as CNS TV's Megan Todaro tells us, one historic site has opened its doors for a bit more than some freebies.
I figured if there's free food and they're welcoming me, why not?
On any other Tuesday, Renee Tianquinco would be sitting at his desk at the Department of Education. But with the government closed for business, Tianquinco and several other federal workers decided there was a better way they could spend their time off, thanks to Sixth and I Synagogue.
We could all very well be sitting at home, moping and lamenting our lives.
Synagogue director Esther Safran Foer and her team came up with the idea for Shutdown Central early Monday morning.
We're a community at Sixth and I. We're a cultural community, we're a religious community. We're not traditional. We need to do something for our people. How can we be supportive of people who come here who are part of our, who are essential to our community, even if they're not essential to the federal government?
The idea grew from a simple coffee cafe where people could grab a free cup of joe and do some work to what it is now.
Just like opening our building for people, having activities for them to do, ping pong, West Wing on repeat, food, coffee, Wi-Fi, just sort of like a space where the community can come together.
It may seem like a simple idea, but to workers such as Josh Novikoff, Shutdown Central is so much more than a place to hang out.
I think it's a little bit of levity. It's a place to gather division, especially if the shutdown goes on for a bit.
Esther and her team are happy to help and hope to see Shutdown Central grow within the next few days.
We're just thrilled that we have found a way to support our community. That's what institutions like us should be doing. And, hopefully this doesn't last too long, but we're here as long as it does.
In Washington, D.C., Megan Todaro, CNS TV.
It's almost like a clubhouse for federal employees.
I feel so bad for the little panda there. How's she going to tweet without...
I know. I went to the zoo last weekend, and I mean, she wasn't up for grabs then, but at least I could see her online.
Well, that's Maryland Newsline for tonight. You can find out more about the stories presented here by going to our website, cnsmaryland.org. I'm sorry, cnsmaryland.org. I'm Leslie Spacek.
And I'm Christina Gatti. Don't forget to check out our CNS Facebook page as well. You can find us at Maryland Capital News Service. Have a good night, and we'll see you back here tomorrow.